So friends, today I will tell you how to perform J unit testing, and I am going to tell this thing to you in a very simple fashion, and you can understand with the help of one very easy example. First of all, I am going to write a very simple program that is to be tested. So you can see my program, that public class test fpatch. Just I selected one name according to my students. Now I created two methods there. The first method it is doing it is getting the maximum value of an array. So many elements are available inside an array, and we are selecting the maximum value from all these, and that will be returning maximum value from that. So I think this function is clear to you. And the second, in that I am just adding two integer values A and B are to be added, and it will be returning result C. So you have to be very careful about all these things, like public static int. So in this I am returning integer value, in this also I am returning integer value, and that is mentioned here in the signature of my method. So this is my program, and you are looking very well that I have not included any public static void main. So this function can be compiled only, it cannot be run, because public static void main is not there. So if I want to test that in a very simple fashion, then I can create public static void main, and then I am calling everyone, and I am filling the values manually, and then I am testing. But now, in which way I have to test that with the help of JUnit that is supported by NetBean. So what NetBean you are having, it depends upon that. If it is not having the plugin of NetBean, then you have to, if it is not having the plugin of JUnit with NetBean, then you have to download that from internet with the help of this just you can see plugins there, and then you have to find out what plugin is available or what is not available. So from this place you can install that plugin, but in my NetBean it is already available. So what you have to do, just you have to go on this, just once more you can see, just click, right click here, and then new, and then you will be seeing test for existing class. So it is JUnit test for the existing class, and all the methods will be created automatically. If it is not available here, then go in others, and many times, or when you are doing it first time, then it will not be available. Then you will see unit test there, and test for existing class, you can select it from this place. So it is available in my NetBean already, because I perform this test many times, and that is why you are seeing it in this list. When I am going on new, and you are looking.
हेलो दोस्तों, हमारी वीडियो को लाइक एवं सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें. आपको हमारी वीडियो को लाइक करने के लिए इस आइकन पर क्लिक करना होगा, तथा सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए आपको इस बॉक्स पर क्लिक करना पड़ेगा. आप हमारी वीडियो को सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए इस बेल आइकन पर भी क्लिक कर सकते हैं. इन दोनों का एडवांटेज आपको ये रहेगा कि जब भी हमारी कोई नई एक इंटरेस्टिंग वीडियो आएगी, तो आपके YouTube अकाउंट के टॉप पर बेल आइकन पर एक अलर्ट आ जाएगा.
In this list here, okay. But as I told you, if it is not available in your NetBean, then you can go in others. Once more I am telling, and then unit test. If it is unit test is not there, then you have to install plugin. So you can go from this place also. So just close it, and now because it is available in my NetBean here, so new, and then just test for existing class, perform it. And now which class is to be tested, you have to browse that here. So test fbatch I am giving, and then test fbatch class is to be tested, that is having two methods. So one is the finding the maximum value from an array, and second thing, just addition of two number, very simple. Just finish it. Now that test has been created automatically. Now you can see here how many things are there. So right now don't concentrate on all these things, all are the methods, they are coming automatically. Now two test has been created. First one you are looking here, that first test that has been created, it is for the testing of array function, that will be finding the maximum value. And second test that has been created for the add function. So whenever we are testing any function that is having two arguments and returning value 1, then we will be giving two input value and two output value. So that is why we are giving two input values there and one output value there. So this is my expected result. Now this add function is to be called. Now a will be passed here, you are looking a, so 4 will be passed there, 5 will be passed there, but I am writing a wrong value. So what is the addition of these two? That is 9. So now assert equal function, equals function will be called, that will be having expected result and the actual result of the method, actual result of the method. Okay, expected result is 9 and the actual result will be coming there, and it both will be compared. On the basis of that, this test will be performed and you will be getting the output. Same thing is here, I am giving 1, 4, 15 and 2. All are the values of an array, and out of all these, what value will be the maximum value? 15 will be the maximum value. So my expected result will be 15. Now result that is to be find by the array. Now I am calling find max function there, and now it will be calculating the result. So assert equals will be called for this also, and expected result will be put there, and the real result or the actual result will be putting. We are putting there. Now just go here and run it and see the result. Tool, window, output window. Go to the window and see the output of that. That is there or not? I think I made that small. Okay, it is there. So just once more run it and see the result. So result is available there. Test add function has been tested, and test find max, this function has also been tested. Now once more I am going to run that with the wrong result. Either my logic is wrong or I am putting the expected result wrong. So just go back and try to run it, and you can see that easily what is wrong there. Now my one test is okay, but another one is wrong, and it is telling you what reason is there. So you can see here it was expected 15, but result is what it is telling. Expected result was 15, but we are putting 10 at that place, that is why this result become fail. So thank you friends. If you have any query or any doubt, then you can put that in my comment, and then you can see that. Okay, thank you.